Hi, everybody. Welcome. If you are joining in, you have signed up for the Attleboro Whitehawks cheer paint night. And if you're watching this video, it means you could not join us live, which is okay. So we are going to get started. In your kits, you got your canvas, your package of paint brushes, two sponge brushes, and some chalk, as well as your black, silver, white, and blue paint. Here you can see that my canvas is, as well as your stencils and some stickers for you. You can see here that my canvas is square, but we are going to be using an 11 by 14 canvas today. And we are going to get started. If you've ever done a paint class with me, I'm doing them for 5 years. We usually have these easels and these really great paint brushes and aprons. And that kind of started in the beginning of the pandemic. But unfortunately, the pandemic lasted a lot longer than we had anticipated. And getting materials to sanitize everything, to take them back and to put them back out to the public again, just became really risky. So everything you guys have is for yours to keep. I do not recommend keeping the sponge brushes after today because they will get crusty. But we are going, actually, nope. I only washed my last sponge brush. We're not going to wash these sponge brushes. We're going to hold our canvas horizontally. And as you can see, I have my wonderful paper towels right here. Before you get started, you're going to want a cup of water. As you can see, it's dirty from my earlier painting. And you are going to need your sponge brushes. Cola out of there. Nobody's seen that. Look what you can see over there. I'm real sorry. So anyways, let us get started. We are going to start by painting the background. I'm going to pull you a little bit closer. There we go. You're going to take your sponge brush and your blue paint, and you're going to cover your whole canvas. A little bit of this paint does go a long way, and we do not want globs. This is just the background. With a sponge brush, it tends to leave strokes on the paint or on the canvas. If you want a more solid background instead of this kind of textured background, you can let this dry and give it a second coating. I am not going to do that today, just for time saving. This canvas is super fun and is meant for all ages. We had a lot of cheerleaders joining in with their adults Thursday, and it was so nice to see everybody. But if we missed you, we missed you. And not everybody is painting blue. You can do this with any school color or league color. I like to listen to jazz when I'm painting, or when I'm with kids, I'll listen to Disney favorites on Amazon. This is Jazz Standards Station. Now, like I said, a little bit of this paint goes a long way. And you don't want to leave huge globs of paint on your canvas. That way it will dry faster. If you have an adult near you, or you are an adult and you have a hair dryer, go ahead and grab it. Oh, I just hit my computer. You can go ahead and grab it and dry your canvas in between. This is our first dry session. So I am going to let it sit. This does need to be completely dry for our next step, which is stenciling. So I am going to put this down because we don't think we need it. Oh, you are going to need to wash it. I think in the kits I actually, no, I only gave you one sponge brush. So you will need to wash it. In order to wash it, just mix it around in this jar of water. I've been doing paint parties for 5 years, paint and craft. Oh, that's it. I've been doing craft parties and paint parties for 5 years. This was my first virtual fundraiser, and I've been virtual. It'll be a year in March. I'm thankful that places are able to have materials again. It was really hard. Let me turn this down. It was really hard in the beginning of the pandemic. I was fortunate to have so many things on hand because I just had a bunch of stock. So actually, my very first virtual paint party was free. And I'm actually thinking about doing like a 1 year raffling off a paint party. for the 1 year anniversary of being virtual. My 5 year anniversary just came up. So that was exciting. So I washed my sponge brush. I'm sure there's still some blue paint in there. That's okay. We're going to be using black paint with this, so it's really not going to matter. And we're going to be doing our megaphone and a bunch of chalk stenciling next. Excuse me. I did not grab a water. Let me stand this up so you guys can see. Usually I have a bottled water with me because I do a lot of talking. We did these Tuesday night and the video is posted finally. I know it took me a little while. It's a lot easier to do this live, like it's a class, instead of trying to re-record it and voice over and attach it together. And then the file's too large to share. And it was such a pain. So I'll be doing these live. You're going to be seeing a whole lot more of these live videos to paint along. I might even redo some of my favorites over the past year just to have them posted. I am super fortunate to be doing a fundraiser at the end of March, and this is what we'll be painting. So those signups will be posted. Very exciting. My canvas is still wet. This is matte paint, so I will know that it is dry when I tilt it and it is no longer shiny. So you can see it's still super shiny. I've got little patches of non-shiny spots. That's where it's dry. This blue definitely does take a lot longer than the black to dry, which is interesting. You will need your chalk and your stencils. So I am going to apologize ahead of time because the stencil that I have left after my stencil, it was used and abused. This is the only thing I have left. This little megaphone. Now, you guys got a square almost the size of your canvas, and on them are cursive letters. And I do have a piece of, I'm so embarrassed. I do have a piece of the stencil left. See how used it was. It has an A in it. This is why I saved it because I wanted to shade the A. And then it has the cursive letters. I gave you lowercase cursive letters because that typically tends to be the harder part of this is when people are writing their names. One, you do not have to use the stencil. You do not even have to do cursive. There are several fonts that you could choose from. And you know, we'll go over that when I start writing my, trying to say, oh, my canvas is almost ready. I still got a little bit of wetness down at the bottom. And, you know, the first time I heard this song, where all my old painters at? This song was in Richie Rich. And this is how their parents opened the vault. Just a little movie trivia. Let's see. Yeah, it's so as I tilt it, you can see I just have it right down here where the paint tended to be a little bit thicker anyway. Like I said, you can see the strokes in my canvas. I'm going to leave it as the textured background. I kind of like the look. But if you want it to be more of this, and even this one isn't as solid, but you can see that it's not as streaky. Do a second coat. You have enough blue in your, or whatever color you're working with. It might not be blue. Once you are ready and your canvas is dry, we are going to start adding our stencil for our megaphone. We're going to do the megaphone first, and then we'll go in and do our names or whatever we're writing and our background afterwards. But for now, you're just going to center that megaphone. You can put it on the side if you want to write something down here. You can do whatever you want. And that was the beauty. And what I stressed to my painters on Thursday is that this canvas is more not a paint along, even though we are painting along together. But it really is just kind of your own poster for yourself. Maybe you want to do stripes in the background. Maybe you just want to do polka dots in the background. I do stars and swirls. I did swirls on one and just stars on the other. You can do whatever you want. And that's the beauty of this canvas, is that it really, really promotes that independent creativity. So just think about what you would like while we're starting our stenciling. So we have our chalk, and you're just going to lightly trace around. Now, something I haven't mentioned yet, but I always tell all of my painters is that once you have painted your canvas with acrylic paint and it is dried, there can be no mistakes. Any wet paint that ends up on your canvas afterwards can be wiped off with a damp paper towel, and you just gently wipe it. Some of the background might come up, but you can just repaint over that background. And as for the chalk, and I will demonstrate right now, I have a mark of chalk. I don't want on my, actually, I can just use this. I don't want on my canvas. You just take a damp paper towel and tap it. You don't want to wipe because it's not paint. It's not sticking there. It'll come right off. So damp it or dap it. So that way you don't ruin your canvas, your painting. So you have your sponge brush again. You are going to take your black paint. I might need to get more black paint. It is really hot. I am currently painting, and I apologize for clearing my throat. I'm currently painting in my little area that I have in my house, and it is small, but it is a place that is mine, and, you know, Jeff and the kids don't come in here. But it heats up real quick. It gets really hot fast. So now we're just going to take our sponge brush, and you might, for this part of your canvas, you might want to use your rectangular brush. When I say that, I mean, it's either a white or brown bristle, but it's a rectangle. The other brush you're going to be using is a detailed brush, and that looks like this. But you're going to be using your sponge brush, a rectangular brush, and this brush, or the sponge brush, I should say. So I'm just going to paint in. Now we are going to trace around this outline with silver. So if the outside of your megaphone is not completely covered, don't worry. As of course, I know. It's all rough looking. No, my megaphone's getting wide. That's okay. So I'm just going to paint in my megaphone. Now, I'm going to show you what you want to avoid are these big, here, let me get a good one, are these big globs of paint. We don't want that. Like I said, a little bit of this paint goes a long way. And if we have those big globs, and as you can see, that a little bit of a paint goes a long way. It just, that little glob just finished this megaphone. When we use globs of paint, it just takes a really long time to dry, and we don't want that. So now I'm going to go in with my rectangular brush. And fill in the mouthpiece. And then I'm also going to add our little handle for our megaphone. Now, you don't have to. You don't need to add a little handle at all. I do. Oh, I think I just got paint in my eye. Look at that. So I said this is the second video I'm recording today. If you watched the last video, if you're watching both these videos, it's been very difficult for me to upload these videos, like I've said. And so going live, you're going to be seeing a whole lot more lives just because it's so much easier to get this out to you guys. So I'm sorry if I mumble or repeat things. I don't want you to miss anything, and I don't want to forget anything. So now what we have to do, though, is let this dry completely. I say let it dry completely. I will probably not let mine dry completely because I will start working on the background for you guys to save time. I do recommend letting this megaphone dry completely for the sake of when you go to add in that chalk, especially if you don't have a canvas and your canvas, you don't have an easel and your canvas is laying down flat. You don't want your arm in this megaphone and getting black paint everywhere. So let it dry. If you have a hairdryer or an adult near you has a hairdryer, blast this canvas, get it nice and dry so you can continue. But the next step that you're going to take once your megaphone is dry, or if you're 100% confident you're not going to mess this up, and I'm not even 100% confident right now that I'm not going to mess this up. But like I said, pause it if you need to, but I'm going to move on. And I'm going to add some stars. Because we're painting our stars in white, we're going to make those old-fashioned, you know, I know there was a big thing going around social media on how you draw your stars reveals all these things. And I kind of laughed because I've drawn them all sorts of ways. Now, little pieces of chalk are getting into my paint right now, into my black paint, which is another reason why you guys should let it dry, because it'll be easier to remove the chalk if it was dry as opposed to being wet. It'll tend to stick. So I'm adding these stars. I'm actually going to add a couple coming out. Lift this up. And I'll add, see what happened. I gotta make sure that dries before I add white paint to it. See? All right, so I'm just gonna leave it like that. We're gonna go in and fill this in afterwards. This star is struggling down here. Oh, this poor little star. There we go. Fat him up. All right, so when you are done, you can use either your rectangular brush or your detail brush and your white and just go over. Actually, I'm going to use my detail brush and just go over your stars and paint them in. Now for this one, I'm going to do stars and polka dots. Like I did in my class, I did stars and spirals. For my original, I did stars and like little asterisks with polka dots. Now, again, if you find yourself getting a drip of paint in a place that you do not want, while it's still wet, take a damp paper towel and gently rub it off. Do not wipe too hard. You don't want to try to remove the paint, but a couple light wipes on the canvas and you should be good.
They're only made of clay, but our love is here to stay.
I almost got my elbow in paint. I am one of the messiest painters, which is why Jeff made sure I had a spot. He was sick of me in the kitchen, taking up all of the space with all of my stuff.
But
Oof, this poor star down here. This canvas, it just makes me so happy and brings back so many cheer memories, like making posters.
I'm riding high and I approve of the trend. Look what I found me. Myself a gentleman friend. The sunny sky seems like.
Now we're gonna go around these, and my megaphone is almost done, or it's almost dry.
This kind of kissing suits me to a T. What I've been missing in the used to be, I'm getting frequently, and so goodbyes it can't stand how me. Is it any wonder I want to laugh and sing and cry? Gonna love him till I die, my gentleman friend.
Oh, you know what? I definitely have to do the cardinal one. That's what we have to do. I was thinking about all the ones that I wanted to redo. And some of them I have to do just because. Ooh, all right. So now I'm going to take my silver. That looks nasty. Sometimes it like dries a little bit around the edge. Ooh, so gross. All right. So I got some silver paint. Now you guys got them all in little cups. I'm going to take my detail brush, that little thin one. Look at messy painter. And I am gonna do these kind of. I'm only gonna do it to the top portion for now, because I want to move on to the writing in the megaphone. It's almost dry, and I want these to dry down here, so I don't run a risk of. Running my arm in it. And I'll show you the other two again afterwards so you can see what it looked like or what they looked like.
Oh, it's your rather be a mule. A mule is an animal with long, funny ears. He kicks up at anything he hears. His back is brawny and his brain is weak. Just plain stupid with a stubborn streak. And by the way, if you hate to go to school, you may grow up to be a mule. How would you like to?
And of course, I just said I wasn't going to do my stars, and then I got lost in, I mean, the dots down below. Then I got lost in the moment and did my dots down here. That's what happens. I just get in a zone. And that's exactly what you want to happen while you're doing something like painting or reading or gardening or cooking, anything like that, where you're doing something with your hands, welding, glass blowing, all of these crazy things that you see. You know, people creating, if you get in the zone, you know, that means you're just in it, and that happens to me way too much. All right, so now I'm just going to go in and add my little dots.
How would you like to swing on a star, carry moonbeams home at a dark?
I think I'm going to do AWH in my mega. Actually, no, because I got to do cursive. Let's see. What should I put in here? I'm going to go through and do a couple more dots because I think I want it to be really spotty. What am I going to write?
Every day you meet quite a few. So you see, it's all up to you. You can be better than you are. Could be swinging on a star.
Oh, I like this painting. I like this spotty background. All right. Let's see. I guess I will just write Attleboro again. And I'm going to start when you're doing your cursive and you're using your, I'm not going to use my stencils for the lettering. It's a little bit easier for me. I've been do a lot of writing on canvases for you. I would definitely suggest doing using the stencils. And what you want to do is you want to find your middle letter. So for, I'll grab my name. My I is the middle. So I started with my I and then I went T-H-A and then I wrote backwards or I guesstimated where it would start and it was pretty easy. So I, you know what, I guess I'll just do Tabitha again, and I don't think if I have any friends I want to make this for. Yeah. What? See, that was too close. Let's try that again. So I just took my damp. Now, you might not get it all off, and that's okay. When we go back through, and after we trace it over, so we need our A-B-I. And I'm going to erase this ending A and just make it a little bit smaller. I got a little He-Man with that A. Now I am writing it from the side, so it's a little bit trickier. Take your time. And then I use the A stencil. Nope, that's the football stencil. Wrong stencil. Now this one's big. I'm not going to use this one. I'm just going to write my own A. But your cursive letters are a lot smaller than this as well. And I'll go in afterwards and add in my details. So now I'm just going to take my brush off too. Got some dirty brushes over here. I'm going to clean off my detail brush. Get my white and start going over my name. Need to get some more white on my paint. Oh, that's silver. All right. So, like my other canvas, it will not look like my sample. And that is because you are human. Yours will not be perfect, and that is okay. The importance is that you are getting creative, working that right side of the brain, and having a good time. Just writing my name here with my detail brush. You just want to use the end of your brush, going very lightly. I am resting my arm on the bottom of my easel to study my hand. Sometimes you'll see me with my pinky out, resting it on the canvas, and helping me paint that way. You want to find something to anchor yourself to help you with these lines. If you feel like your hand is starting to get really shaky, that tends to be a problem when you start to hyper-focus and you're, I gotta fix this bee because that looks hideous. And once you hyper-focus, you put a lot of pressure and energy into your hand and then your hand starts shaking and it starts cramping. If that happens, take a step back, do a couple hand stretches, shake it out. When we paint our names, when we paint these fine shapes, I always tell people to let the idea of painting an I or the letter T go and just focus on the fact that you're just painting a line. And that's why we have these chalk outlines. So we don't have, we can take the pressure off of thinking about what we're actually doing and we can just go with the flow, which is part of the process that you definitely want. Kind of just letting go, following the guides. Oh, my skinny brush has seen its day. These brushes, you know, the ones that you get in your kits, not the ones that we paint in our class. When we have in-person classes, my brushes are actually really expensive. And I give this whole spiel about how these brushes are my best friends. And you don't want to give them, you know, you don't want your best friends to have bad hair days. So make sure you wash your brushes. But these brushes are inexpensive. And that's why, you know, we're able to give them out and not have to worry about taking them back. Now you can notice that I did not paint over my chalk. I'm going to erase that once everything is dry. And I'll erase that once that's dry. I'm gonna go over to my A and I'm gonna make this a little bit thicker. And then I'm gonna add my bars afterward to give it that varsity font. Now you can do your whole name in this varsity font that I'm about to show you. Like I said, you could do it earlier where you leave it like this, where you do just a straight font. Or a classic font, and you add little dots to the end. And I'll go in and add my bars. There you go. Now, I have not done it yet, and I'm going to do it right now. Is outline everything in silver with my detailed brush. So I washed off my brush, I dried it, and you want to make sure you always dry your brushes because this is acrylic paint. When you start with your outlining silver, make sure you start at the top. And you don't want to touch your canvas. So if this is something you want to wait until when everything is dry, I would suggest that. Like I said earlier, you'll see me going pretty fast through this only just to save time. You know, you don't want to hear me. I love these little dots. Oh, I just got some black paint in my silver. All right, I'm so excited. We're finishing up. Oh, there's some black paint under my silver. I'm like, where is it coming from? And of course, this paint fundraiser was decided right before they found out their season is a go. So that is super exciting. And I'm going to go around the whole megaphone as well. And then, like I always tell my artists, make sure you initial somewhere. Now, we kind of laughed in the class because we weren't quite sure. I guess you sign it. Doesn't matter whose name you painted on. Oh, I'm getting black in this silver down here. Oh, it's on my paint. You guys are using a cup, so it's a little bit easier to keep your paint separate. Mine are on a plate, just so I save my cups. You know, being in the pandemic, it's really taught me like what you actually need. And it's the bare minimum, you know, to be successful. You don't need the fancy brushes. But you might need stencils. I've used a lot of stencils during this pandemic, because if I can't be there with you in person, it's a little bit trickier. All right, now I'm going to paint around my... Oh, you know, I just realized I forgot to cross my T with my paint, so I'll do that afterwards. Like I said, when in doubt, pinky out. I guess I want to silver paint. Oh, that's, I don't want to pour. Whoa. Whoops. Just pour that baby right out. All right. Once I am done with this, I can post these right to the groups too. So that's exciting, because I know a couple people have been waiting for them. And I'm so sorry. Like I said, until last night, I didn't even know I could go on YouTube Live to record this and that it would save the video and make it so it was easily shareable. That is the tricky part to my software, which I'm sure there's, you know, software out there that just makes life so much easier, but it's not me. Okay, cool. Let me continue down here. I was like straight black. I just keep trying to put silver over black, and the black paint's like, no, I'm here. I'm not dry yet. Okay, so once that is a little bit more dry, but I am going to wash this off and get some white paint, because that is what I'm going to use to cross my T first and foremost. And then I'm going to sign my T down in my bottom canvas, because I painted it. Then what you're going to do is you're going to let this canvas sit and you're going to let it fully dry. I would recommend waiting until tomorrow to take your damp paper towel and tapping it on your canvas to pull up all of that chalk dust and any unwanted chalk that you have in areas that you do not want. But other than that, here is your canvas. And I thank you so much for joining me today, for supporting the league, or, you know, representing your schools, your towns, whoever you're painting this for. This was so much fun to do with you guys, and I was glad to help you. So thank you, and have a great night.